I am Dr. K. Asogan, Associate Professor at Department of EEE, GC Bargur. I am going to explain the experimental setup of a W field induction generator. The W field induction generator are purchased from the TechCube 3 for ME power electronics students. It is the total cost of the W field induction generator is 9,60,000 and the installation date is 10/9/2019. Generally, the W field induction generator is one of the good generator. It generates the power, it gives the constant output when varying the input speed or frequency. Here no matter for the varying the speed or frequency, in all time it gives the constant output power. The W field induction generator having the two parts are there, that is the stator and the rotor. The stator of the W field induction generator is connected to the wind turbine. The wind turbine are connected to the stator of the W field induction generator. So in this experiment, the varying the frequency or varying the speed, the corresponding the grid power, stator power and grid converter power all are noted. Now I am going to explain the experimental setup and the functions of W field induction generator. As shown in this figure, it having the three main parts are there. This is the panel board of the W field induction generator. This is the W field induction generator. This is the auto transformer of the circuit. Generally, the W field induction generator input is the wind power. Here, the wind power is not available. So, the three-phase AC motor are coupled with the W field induction generator. So now I am going to explain the panel board. So in this panel board having the test terminal, this is the pulse width modulation, signals of the voltage source inverter 1. This is the feedback signals of VSI, voltage source inverter 1. This is the meter. This is the display the frequency of the frequency of the signal. This is the pulse width modulation signals for voltage source inverter 2. This is the feedback signals for the voltage source inverter 2. So the two voltage source inverters are considered in this experimental setup. This is the IGBT based voltage source inverter 1. This is the voltage source inverter 2. The two voltage source inverter are connected here. So in this inverter, the DC is the DC supply is the input of the inverter. The AC is the output of the inverter. This is the two inputs are connected with the DC supply. Then this is the output of the inverter. The inverter 1, this is the inverter 2. This is the variable frequency drive. So when the varying the frequency by using this knob, the corresponding the speed of the double field induction generator are varied. Now I am going to the operations of double field induction generator. Now, this is the three-phase supply is given here. The three-phase supply is given into the auto transformer. The another one is the three-phase supply is given to the panel board of the double field induction generator. The auto transformer are used to regulate the three-phase AC supply. When adjust the voltage up to 230 volt, the induction motor, the motor should be on and give a coupled with the induction generator. Now the varying the auto transformer up to the rated speed of 230 volt. This is in the MCP switches. The switches all are on. So here the three displays are there. The first display is the grid power display. This is the stator of the double field induction generator. This is the grid side converter power supply. All are displayed in this meter. Now, the adjust the voltages up to 230 volt. The adjust the 230 volt. The motor is now into the on. Now, all switches are now will be on. Now the motor will be run at the rated speed. When
the motor are reaching the rated speed or the synchronous speed of 1500 rpm, the generator are try to generate the power. The generated power are noted in the displayed in this meter. So it is the grid meter. Now the pressing the P terminal of the display, the corresponding the power are noted here. So in this experimental setup, the varying the frequency, that is the 45 hertz to 60 hertz, the corresponding the speed are noted. The speed will be increased when the output values of converter power, stator power and grid power all are noted. So in this experiment, the frequency up to going to 50 hertz, the generated power become the positive. After 50 hertz, the generated power become the negative. All are tabulated by using the tabular diagram, then do the calculations. So this experiment is very useful for the PG students for doing the project, the various project and the research work by using the double pole induction generator. Thank you.